Good morning, everyone. I'm coming to you this morning live from A Better You, which is brought to you by United Healthcare and AARP. I'm going to be talking to Miss Ernestine Shepherd soon. If you don't know who she is, you better Google her. World's oldest female bodybuilder.
Stay tuned. We were singing oldies, but they were newies now. And today when I play my old 45s, I remember when.
This like that. And I said, Yanni, where are you? Because you made me do this stuff. Yanni, where are you?
Come on, feeling good. And she put a little hot sauce on top of that push-up. Throw the leg up in the air.
Shepherd. If you don't know who she is, I suggest you go ahead and Google her. But just to save you a little time, I'll let you know. She is the world's, I don't want to say oldest because she looks like a young flower. She's the world's oldest bodybuilder. She's a fitness guru. She is a legend. And she is here with us today to talk to our group. Fitness is not a game. And I just wanted to ask her a few questions. She just got off the stage. She just told us so many wonderful stories. She had me crying, so I'm hoping my makeup isn't messed up. But I love my sister so much, so your story really touched me. That's my sister right here filming us, and we go everywhere together.
That is wonderful.
I'm the bad one.
Okay. It's always one.
And she just got off stage. She told us an amazing story about how she got started, the ages she got started, and everything. And I just wanted to take some time out and have her talk to us today. The first question I want to ask you, just for our audience sake, is what was your main motivation to get started at such a late age with your health and fitness?
My main motivation was a vain one. It was because my sister and I didn't like how we looked in bathing suits. That was my motivation in the beginning. Then after that, when my sister died, that became a great motivation for me because I wanted to fulfill everything that Velvet stated that she wanted to do. And with God's help, I have been able to fulfill everything that Velvet has wanted.
Thank you. That's such a beautiful story. How do you maintain it? You had mentioned that your sister has been passed on. May she rest in peace. So how do you maintain it?
Well, I keep going because I enjoy it now. And then plus, I know that there are so many people who need help and need to hear what I have to say. And maybe that will help them to move along, and then it helps me knowing, and I keep using that word help, it helps me knowing that I'm helping others to live a healthy, happy, positive, confident lifestyle.
Awesome. Okay, so our group Fitness is Not a Game. It's very serious about health. It has a lot of members of different stages of their fitness levels. What advice can you give somebody that's starting out now that might be scared to start?
A person that's starting out now, if they visit their doctor first and he gives them the good okay, start out just with a walking program. Walking is very good. Start off with walking at least 15 to 30 minutes a day. Then after you get yourself in shape with the walking, then incorporate some type of exercise such as weight training, which is very, very important because you don't want to do one without the other. Each helps the other.
That's awesome. And what about your diet? Is there a special diet that you're using?
I eat the same way day in and day out. I drink liquid egg whites, which I love. That's my protein. Then I'll eat oatmeal. And then I drink plenty of water. This is my breakfast, mind you. And I have walnuts and I have pineapples. That's in the morning. Does it sound tasty?
It actually does sound tasty. It sounds like it's a lot. Like you could eat much more of that than you could of something that's full of bad stuff.
And then the remainder of the day, I eat maybe 4 to 5 more times.
Okay.
I eat tuna fish, chicken, and turkey. My vegetables are sweet potatoes, white potatoes, brown rice. Then my vegetables have no preservatives in them whatsoever. Spinach, broccoli, I eat some corn, and I like asparagus. Mind you, plenty of water, drink my egg whites at least 5 times a day.
Wow. Okay, now this question is a little bit in vain, but your outfit is like slamming, it's fire. I want to talk about your whole hookup, the coordination that you got going, your nails, everything is perfect. Talk about it.
Well, with my outfits, I have a designer.
Okay.
It's Fena Original. She makes everything for me. The hat, the jacket, the top, the pants, my fancy socks. She didn't make my tiny 2 shoes. I always pretend people tell them I wear a size 2.
Okay.
Tell the truth. My nails, I have them done just about every 2 weeks. I have to have them done. And my mantra on my pants, I have that on there. Determined, dedicated, disciplined to be fit. I have to have everything magic.
Okay, so I wanted to end with your mantra. You already did. So can you go ahead and just give us your mantra one more time?
My mantra is determined, dedicated, disciplined to be fit. And may I also tell the people where I am today?
Yes, please do.
I am at the Ivy Community Center. I'm in Atlanta, Georgia. Of course you know that. But I want to tell you, don't let that rain stop you. Come on out. We're having fun. You learn a lot. I'm with United Healthcare, and it's called A Better You. And to find out being a better you, come on out. Please don't stay home. We want you here. Everything is free. Are you coming? I think I hear you saying yes. See you then.
Okay, you guys, you heard her. We're at the Ivy Community Center here in Atlanta. The next session is, I believe, at 2 o'clock?
2:30.
Come on down. I know it's raining, but Miss Ernestine has made her way here to be with us. We're having a ball. If you follow me on Twitter or Facebook, you already heard me say that I'm starting to hang around older people now. I'm not hanging around with no more younger people because they know how to kick it here. Thanks for tuning in, you guys.
Bye.
Bye.